Yeah, that's the line. That's the line. The line just before the whoa, whoa. What is that lyric? I was bloody right. I knew I was right. Just spoke to Don Mesco, and it's burn and fall is the line.
Burn and fall.
Burn and fall. Yeah. I was right with my line, right. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Well, it's kind of D-Day now. Album's out March 8th. It's the 10th of December. The lads have a serious job on their hands. We've got 10 more vocals to record between now and the end of next week. And
yeah, but we're up for it.
The boys are up for it. And it'll be interesting. Heads are down. Focus. Let's go.
Did he say anything during the night, did he?
I think maybe it might have been difficult in the early years for the youngest member of the band to be trying to help other people in the band or to be taking the reins in any way. And they're happy to, you know, let me do what I do. You know, let me take the reins. Let me, you know, step up to the plate when it's needed.
Boyzone worked principally because you had Ronan and Stephen at the forefront with the other guys playing a supporting role. And I struggled with that for years and years because I didn't feel as everybody feels, I suppose. I don't know how anybody can ever become completely settled with playing a supporting role. You know, everybody wants to be lead man in a movie one day.
The last one was good. The last one was good, the third.
Yeah, we all battled with our roles in the band and who we were and who was doing this and who was doing that. Oh, we were kids, man. We were kids. We wanted things. That's what it is. It's selfishness. It's ego. I was 16 when I joined the band. I was only a baby when I came into this band. And I worked extremely hard in the 6 years to make Boyzone the best it could be. And I think at a time I probably felt a little bit resentful, maybe, that I didn't even realise how hard I had worked.
I know what's important in life now to me, and my younger egotistical problems are not really what it's all about.
Mikey, what do you fancy doing?
Whatever falsettos you need for
us. Oh yeah, the falsettos.
This is, you know, what fate has decided the story of Boyzone is to be. And I'll just, to the best of my ability, do that, you know. Make Stephen proud, make the boys proud. And this is the shape of things now. This is something that we, hard as it is, have to accept.
Let it go. Don't be scared to breathe again. It's all right.
It's lovely.
Close your eyes and together we can feel what it's like.
I think we all felt pressure by standing into what we thought we had to fill a pair of shoes. We didn't realise that, lads, you are Boyzone, you still are who you are. Nobody has to fill anything. And I just think we initially got it wrong in the beginning by thinking, oh my God, I've got to sing a song, I've got to do this verse, I've got to do that verse. But also we were encouraged to do that because it gave us something to focus on.
You know, we're still gathering our thoughts and the album has, though we never expected it to be this way, it has acted and is acting as a therapy and a stability in a storm, really, to be honest with you.
So we've tried over the last few months to find a new sound and a new band and a new balance. You know, so other people have been, you know, trying to push other people in studio to get them out there and do lead vocals. And because if it was just me, if I just go in and, you know, without Steo and it's just me on the lead on a lot of the tracks, well, then it's my album. It's not Boyzone as it should be. There has to be, so the lads have really stood up to the plate.
All right, who's doing the first pass?
Running?
You do.
Okay. Ronan has to put a lot more work in than the rest of us because he predominantly is the lead singer in this band. So that means a lot more hours in the studio than the rest of us.
Great, bro.
All right.
Magic.
Cool. There was a hunger for this album. We all went into that studio very, very hungry.
Yeah. That's right.
Silly, man. I don't even, you're asleep with me.
Back to front then.
So, I don't know. I'm making the record and that's the only frame of mind I'm in. I'm not thinking about performing. because I don't know what it's going to be like. I'm not ready for it.
Just arrived at a video shoot for Gave It All Away, which I'm looking forward to hearing because Stephen's vocal should be on the first verse when we hear the song today. So it should be difficult, but I'm looking forward to hearing it as well.
Morning.
Morning.
How are we all doing?
Works every time. Just put the glasses on her so that nobody knows who she is.
Now you won't know her.
I'll be fine. Let's go make some history.
Shooting a video for Gave It All Away was something I went in quite prepared for. And the concept of the video was literally writing the last letter to Theo.
I'm not gonna focus on the words.
Yeah.
The only words I'll ever use in the video is the word dear and the word Theo. Everything else that you write, you fold it up, you put it in, you seal it, it's your gig. No one will ever see that.
Roll playback.
The video came along and a ton of bricks.
Why?
Because it was really evident he wasn't there. Really evident for us all that he wasn't there.
How should I describe it?
It was just this huge hole. It just felt like, you know, this massive gap.
Roll playback.
I was basically kind of saying to him, I'm sitting here on a cold floor, trying to think of words to say to you, don't know what to say to you, and I was having a laugh and a joke with him. And then I actually let my guard down. I think as soon as I let that guard down, for some reason, I listened to the lyrics, which I was just more concentrating on what I was doing in the video, but then I actually let that up and I listened to the lyrics and it hit home. And I felt just inside, I started to rattle inside, and I just could not be there any longer. I had to get up, I had to leave, I just had to get out.
That's hard.
But you know, one of the hardest things, when you start writing, the funny thing is, well, I kind of took my mind off the lyrics and started writing, and then I almost started having a crack, like,
yeah.
You know? One of the hard things is, and I see it just got Duffy as well, when you actually seal the letter, you know, and you write, there's Theo, it's like a defining moment of, that's, it's over.
The day of that video, it was weird, that's when the walls came tumbling in, really. It's hard to know what to say at the end of a day like that. But somehow we managed to get through it. It wasn't easy, very emotional at times. And a lot of fun, though, as well. A lot of good kind of memories and things went through our minds. A lot of happy memories of Steven. Can't believe it, though. Just can't believe it.